In this video, I'll show you how to use the AF Display Builder add-in to quickly make Pi ProcessBook displays containing AF attributes. The AF Display Builder add-in is a new feature to Pi ProcessBook 2014, which I have open right here. The add-in is a really great way to be able to browse your AF hierarchy and easily see the attribute values for elements and add those quickly to the displays. The add-in has two windows which can be enabled if you go under View. So I'm going to select the AF property and the AF browser. So the AF browser window is pulling up the hierarchy from my default AF server, which I can confirm with the ellipses. And I have this particular AF database, my Win database selected, which I could have modified from the drop-down menu. And this Win Power Generation Fleet AF hierarchy is divided by wind farms, and each wind farm has several turbines underneath it. And the AF browser and the AF property windows are working together. So I'll select the element in the AF browser, and the AF property window will show all the AF attributes for the selected element. I can even group them by category, which makes it a lot easier if I have a lot of attributes for a given element, and if I don't want to see information like the timestamp or want to see certain information, I can use this little icon drop down here and make some adjustments. These windows are dockable, so I'm going to drag it down here since I'm going to be actually working on building in my display. As you can see, I'm in build mode, and the first thing that I'm going to do is actually use the AF browser to add a symbol that has already been assigned to a given element. So I'm going to select this particular wind turbine, and after I have it selected, I can do a left click to select it, and I can drag it into my display. And right away, I already see a lot of information about this particular turbine. And these items, the turbine name, manufacturer, model, whether it's an alarm state, what the active power is, information regarding the wind speed and the temperature. This is information within our organization we always want to see for a turbine. And we want to make it really easy for anybody who is working off of this AF database build this information into the display in a uniform manner, which is why we did the symbol assignment. Now, there's a couple other things that I'm interested in looking at for this turbine. So I've got that turbine selected. I definitely know I want to, oh yes, I know I want to add the availability and capacity. I can select the availability and I can hold down and drag it to my display. And let me do the same thing with the capacity because I'm interested in that as well. Great. I can even drag and drop attributes into existing trends. So let me use the trend button right here and create a new trend. That's just blank. So I'm not going to bother to select any tags or attributes. I'm going to leave this blank and stick with all the defaults for my trend and hit OK. I want this trend to reflect the power attributes. So I'm going to select these, and again, do a left click and drag and drop. Great. As you can see, I was able to very, very quickly build out a display. One of the things that was particularly useful was bringing in this symbol. Let's talk about how this was done. Within Pi ProcessBook, I can do a right click, say on this trend or any other symbol, and I have some options for assignments right here. And the one that's highlighted is the assign symbol to template, and that's the AF template. Let's say for the wind turbines, in addition to this information presented, our users want to also be able to bring in the availability and the capacity. Now, a template can only have one symbol associated with it. So what I will do is I've selected all of these pieces. I'm going to go up top here to arrange, and I'm going to group them and select yes. What this means is these all now are effectively one symbol. And I'm going to go ahead and assign this particular symbol to the wind turbine template. So I'll do assign symbol to template, and I'm going to select that wind turbine template within this AF database and hit OK. I'm going to get a message because this template already has a symbol associated with it. So I'll need to make a choice if I want to override this setting. And I'm going to go ahead and select yes. Now I'm going to select another wind turbine from the AF browser, hold and drag it. Okay, now you can see that the availability and capacity have been added to the template. And it actually is pretty easy to do a comparison between turbines since I have the information all presented the same way. Now, what type of permissions are needed in order to be able to be making these assignments? Well, if I want to assign a symbol to a template, I have to have write permissions to that template. And you can check in PySystem Explorer to confirm that you have those permissions. What about the other assignment options? We saw the value in assigning a symbol to a template. When would we assign a symbol to an element? That would really make sense if the element that you have created the symbol for is one not based off of a template, or if there's something very specific about that element that needs to get captured. For instance, this particular turbine might have an additional attribute that we monitor that's very important. For example, the tower acceleration. This might not be something that we currently are set up to be able to monitor on our other wind turbines. And we want to additionally add this to that particular element. Let me go ahead and get everything selected here and group again. And I will go ahead now and assign the symbol to the element. And I will see my hierarchy, and I'm going to have to select the element that this is based off of, this GE02 at Big Buffalo Wind Farm, and I'll hit OK. You'll note that I can assign a symbol to a template, and I can assign a symbol to an element that is based off of a template that I've already made the assignment. What this means is from now on, that element will only be showing the symbol that was specific to the element, not the template. And any new changes to the template won't be picked up. Another great option with the AF Display Builder is particularly useful if you're working in a large display with symbols from multiple elements. I have a display like that open, and you can see in this case, it can be pretty challenging to quickly find something for any given element because there's a lot of different things going on. Fortunately, I can use the AF browser and right-click on a specific element and use the locate button. You can see that for this particular element, it has located and even highlighted the particular symbol that's associated with this element. The symbol assignments that I set up earlier in this video required AF write permissions. However, you can still use this locate option in your PyProcessBook displays, even if you don't have write permissions to AF elements or templates. Let me show you how to set that up. For this particular wind turbine that we are looking at, I'm going to add some additional values to this display. And then I'll group them together. Let's say I don't have write permissions to the AF element or AF template, or that I don't even want to make this association in AF. I'll do a right click after I have unselected and then selected again. And I'm going to choose this very last option, assign element to symbol. Keep in mind, this last option is only for making assignments to help locate things in this particular display. And then I can select that particular element. Now when I click on locate on this element, it will find the original AF assignment like before, and I can also move up here and use the edit to look for additional assignments. So I'll hit find next, and you can see that it has also found the new reference. And that new reference is only for this particular display.